What is going on, everybody? It's Lazivo here, and this video is one that I wasn't going to put out until someone asked for it. And the more I thought about it, you know, I have a strong opinion on it, and it's related to the KONY 2012 video. I'm assuming all you guys have seen it. If you're on YouTube, you've probably seen it. It's a viral video. In fact, I just read it's the biggest viral video in YouTube history. Which I guess I saw it coming, but they said it hit. It was the fastest to hit 80 million views ever. So, you know, who knows where it's gonna go? I'm sure everybody's gonna see it. People are gonna watch it multiple times, and so it's gonna be, you know, probably the biggest video ever on YouTube. Now, a lot is being said on it. There's videos all over the internet, and all over YouTube and all over the news. There's a lot of it's funny, but it's created a lot of controversy. And I guess in a way that's good, because what it was designed to do was move people. And it's funny because that's exactly what I felt when I watched it. It was, I felt moved, and you know, it made me think, you know, I had a bunch of thoughts, but it made me think, what is actually happening in the world, and where are people with how we deal with those things? Clearly, Joseph KONY, who is the leader of the Lord's Resistance Army, is a bad dude. Now, one of the criticisms that I've seen is that the film focused a lot on the filmmaker's son. If you've watched it, he's got his little boy in there. He must be, I don't know, three or four years old, something like that, 4 years old. And he's asking him questions. And he's kind of sort of loosely explaining the situation. And his answers, you know, I have a little girl too. His answers are so innocent. And it kind of reminds me that if you strip away everything that we've learned and taught and been taught and all our preconceived notions, we are those innocent kids at heart, and it's easy, it's clear, it's evil and good is so clearly defined that's what makes his answer so key to the movie, is that, you know, he's saying, like, we got to get the bad guy, and you got to strip everything else away. People argue, where does the money go? Where does is Joseph KONY even in Uganda anymore? I've been reading reports that his army's long since moved out of Uganda, and that he's now fighting in the Sudan and Congo, and it's not even an issue for the Ugandan people. Now they're just trying to rebuild, you know, and kind of find homes for all the displaced families and things like that. But I think the point of it is, Joseph KONY is still out there. And regardless of where your dollar goes, or regardless of if he's even in Uganda, and if it even affects the Ugandan people, the point of the video is that there's a bad guy in this world. He's done some horrible, horrible things. He kidnaps children, gives them guns, forces them to fight. If they don't fight, he kills them. Maybe kills someone they love, forces them to kill people they love. Grabs little girls, like my little girl, forces them into sexual slavery, and turns them into sex servants for, you know, whoever. He gets them hooked on drugs, manipulates them, forces them to disfigure people. If you saw the videos, it's disturbing. That's one of the most graphic images in the video, is the, you know, flashes of people with their noses cut and their lips cut off and their face maimed. It's one of the most horrible things you could ever do to a person. And this is the man who orders this. He's numb. He's long since grown up from that little innocent child that we all are. And he has been instilled with some, I'm going to call it, pure evil. And no one's disputing the things that he's done in the video. You don't become the most wanted person by the, you know, international criminal, what is it called, the ICC. I'm looking forward to hearing an article, but you don't become the most wanted person on this list without being, you know, without question, being doing some very, very bad things. And it's International Criminal Court. Sorry, I just found it. But you don't get to that level without being a very, very bad person. And I think that's where the innocence struck me in the video, is that you just see this young kid identifying it so clearly. And why can't we identify it clearly? If you're confused where your dollar goes, the Invisible Children nonprofit charity broke it down on their website. About 37% actually goes to Africa. Now about 25%, I believe, goes to what they're calling awareness. I've heard people say this is, only 37% of my money actually goes to programs in Africa that can actually deal with this, right? But the issue is, prior to this video coming out, they didn't have this gigantic budget. I'm sure now they're going to be flooded with money. In fact, they're telling people, don't give any more money. We don't need it. We don't know what to do with it. And I think the issue prior to this was that no one knew the issue. That's what the video is about, is that we needed to get our point across. We need to make this known. So in term, just as important as helping the people there is getting their message out. And so like when they're spending a third of the money roughly to go out and promote awareness, people get upset. But the idea is you didn't even know about the issue until those dollars went to work and showed you what was actually taking place. Now, I imagine when they get flooded with money like they are now, that awareness issue is no longer going to be the problem. And you should see I would expect to see a shift in those dollars go to more of the things that can actually help the people in Africa, things that can help the people that are fighting to take down KONY. And I guess the last thing I'll say is that the most important thing, or one of the key things that moved me, was the fact that social media has gotten to the point where people are so connected that we can be dangerous. And when I say that, it means these warlords, these people, you're seeing governments being overtaken. You're seeing things like the Occupy movement here in the US. You're seeing people more connected than they've ever been with their messages. And it's a way to say in this, like, what I love about that video is that we're going to use things like Twitter and Facebook and YouTube and all these different aspects, these outlets that are available to us now, this transfer of information, to say, look, we're going to go back and say, we're not going to stand for this stuff in the world, okay? It doesn't matter that it's not going on in our backyard. We have problems here, yes, but we don't have problems like this. We're not losing 30,000 children a year that are being ripped out of their parents' homes and put into an army and given guns. This isn't happening here. So yeah, we have our issues to deal with, but it's like if the earth is a body and we have a scratch here, they're losing a limb over there. So you gotta go where the biggest need is. You know what I'm saying? You gotta say we gotta prioritize this and say this is the big fish. This is the low hanging fruit. Let's go get this guy. Get him out of this. Get him out of the picture. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying kill him. Whatever you want to do with him, just get him out of power. Disperse his army and disperse his army. Sorry, and deal with that. It's a clear, there, it's a cut and dry issue. Just get him out of there and the world will be better off for it. So I love the fact that it's uniting people. I love the fact that it's that it shows just how powerful we can be when we get together. I think it reminded me a lot of like the hippie movement back in the 70s, when you see people that used to congregate in these giant crowds like protesting the Vietnam War in Washington, D.C., and you look at that crowd, and that might have been 100,000 people, something like that. Now we're talking a video that's been seen by 80 million people that are all connected through forums and Facebook and Twitter, and it's just amazing to see how many more people we can pull together now through this thing that we have, this tool that we have called the internet, and how we can pull together. So I hope they catch this guy. I hope we spread the word that things like this just won't stand in the world. And I hope we all go back and find that little kid in us, like the boy in the movie, that innocence that we have, strip away our jobs, our family, things we've been taught and raised with, and just strip those back to just pure innocence, you know, the joy and the love that's in a child, and the understanding of things are simpler when you really, really strip away all these things that we carry with us every day. And, you know, just, I don't know, man, make the world a better place. So, I don't know, maybe you guys don't agree with me, but those are my thoughts. I hope you enjoyed the video. And I don't know what video I'm putting with this. I'm just speaking into my mic here, so this may be a little long. I'm not sure, but anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this. And thanks for listening. I'd love to hear what you guys think. Leave it in the comments. That's it. Thanks.